Raw emotion as passengers on the Nightmare Cruise finally make it back to dry land.
It was just like living on Deadliest Catch. It was horrible. Things were flying off the tables.
Being on a roller coaster for 17 hours in your room, not even tied down. 45-degree angle is hell.
This passenger suffered a black eye.
I was flung about 18 feet across the cabin, hit a door, knocked myself out for about a minute, got this.
This dad was on board the storm-battered ship with his two-year-old.
It got really, really, really bad.
And this guy was in such fear, he recorded a farewell message to his family.
There were seriously moments where I didn't think we were going to make it.
The cruise ship Anthem of the Seas finally docked in Bayonne, New Jersey last night after being battered by a massive storm on its way to the Bahamas. Some of the 4,000-plus passengers described the ordeal like being inside a washing machine. You can see why from this video shot during the storm.
Oh my God.
And look at this video, the deck furniture literally flying around. One passenger posted this onboard weather map showing wind 116 knots. That's about 130 miles an hour. The cruise line continues to come under attack for not heeding warnings about the storm.
So you can see how quickly it developed that strong wind.
A passenger tweeted, "I would rather have Captain Crunch as my captain." Al Roker says the cruise line Royal Caribbean should have known the weather was going to be bad.
They had plenty of warning. Yeah. They made a decision.
One weather service warned 4 days before the ship set sail, storm force winds possible. Royal Caribbean says in a statement, "We apologize for exposing our guests and crew to the weather they faced and for what they went through. We need to do better." The ship finally made it back to port, but because it got here in the middle of the night, some of the passengers had to stay an extra night on the ship. Now the returning vacationers are trying to put the ordeal behind them.
There was moments we were weightless, literally not, we couldn't touch the floor because it's like being in the front of a roller coaster. And other times that we just couldn't even stand because the G-forces.
My daughters were in one of the bars and they said an entire wall of glasses came toppling over.
Everything's flying off the shelves and it was unbelievable. Never been on a ride like that in my life, believe me.
A blessed return to dry land.
Oh my God.